Farnam presents Ultimate Horse Care. Today's topic is feed-through fly control. Dr. Kennedy, where do we start?
Well, we want to start by controlling the two flies that are most important to the horse, and those are stable flies and house flies. And the control of those flies starts with the manure. The manure is a breeding ground and the growth medium for flies. So what we want to do is control either by removing manure, or we want to treat that manure so that it's not hospitable for the flies. One way that we do this, and it's part of a multifaceted control program, is to feed something to the horse, let the horse mix it in, all the manure that goes out the other end of the horse, so that the flies can't grow. What the product does in the manure is, as a fly grows, it reduces his exoskeleton so that they become sort of a blob, a shapeless mass, and they don't pupate and become adult flies. We want this to be available in the manure before the flies start to grow in the spring, before the temperatures reach about 50 degrees, all the way through the first frost of the year. One of the keys to controlling flies is to have this product present in the manure at all times.
Now, does the horse himself absorb any of this chemical?
There's nothing that happens in the horse. It's not absorbed, it's not toxic to the horse, it just passes through the horse, and we use the horse as a mixing vehicle to make sure all the manure is treated. It's only toxic to the flies.
And you just put it right on his feed, and it tastes good enough that he'll eat it?
The product is formulated to be palatable, look just like something the horse is used to eating, an alfalfa pellet, very palatable and very digestible for the product to release in the horse.
How quickly does it begin to work once the horse has started on that program?
It works as soon as the first manure is deposited from that horse.
To learn more, visit FarnamHorse.com. Farnam, your partner in horse care.